The incident occurred in the traffic separation scheme in the Straits of Dover, in the northeast direction lane of the scheme, off Cape Grinet. The incident occurred during the day in dense fog and moderate seas. Bulk carrier E was proceeding at 14 knots on a heading of 020 degrees, while another vessel C was proceeding at 16 knots on a heading of 039 degrees and slowly gaining on vessel E. Tank barge I was proceeding on a heading of 240 degrees at a speed of 11 knots and was proceeding in the wrong lane of the separation scheme. Another, unidentified vessel was also heading northeast, slightly west of ships E and C. At a time of 10 minutes before collision, C minus 10, ship C has just passed along the stern of E, and both vessels had become aware of ship I coming towards them in the wrong lane. At a time of 6 minutes before collision, C minus 6, ship I changed her course to starboard in two small alterations and became on a collision course with ship E. Consequently, ship E reacted to this change by also turning to starboard. At a time of 4 minutes before collision, C minus 4, ship C was still maintaining its original steady course and speed. Ship E, being aware of ship C, reduced its starboard turn to go back on its original course. The southwestbound barge I also started to turn slowly to port in order to come back on its original course and pass between ship E and the unidentified vessel. At a time of 2 minutes before collision, C minus 2, ship C gave the order hard to starboard, and being now aware of imminent danger, ship E gave the order hard to port, and ships C and E collided into the side of each other. A few seconds later, the stern of C once again struck the starboard side of ship E. Both vessels sustained damage, but could continue on their own power. In your opinion, which vessel violated which rule? Click on the buttons for a quick overview of the relevant rules. Rule 6, safe. Rules. Extract from Rule 6, safe speed. Every vessel shall at all times proceed at a safe speed so that she can take proper and effective action to avoid collision and be stopped within a distance appropriate to the prevailing circumstances and conditions. Rule 10, traffic separation schemes. Type your answer in the space below. Click Done, Print button to lock your answer. If you have an attached printer, extract from Rule 7, Risk of Collision. A. Every vessel shall use all available means appropriate to the prevailing circumstances and conditions to determine if risk of collision exists. If there is any doubt, such risk shall be deemed to exist. B. Proper use shall be made of radar equipment if fitted and operational, including long-range scanning to obtain early warning of risk of collision and radar plotting or equivalent systematic observation of detected objects. Extract from Rule 8. Action to avoid collision. V. Any alteration of course and or speed to avoid collision shall, if the circumstances of the case admit, be large enough to be readily apparent to another vessel observing visually or by radar. A succession of small alterations of course and or speed should be avoided. D. Action taken to avoid collision with another vessel shall be such as to result in passing at a safe distance. The effectiveness of this action shall be checked until the other vessel is finally passed and clear. Extract from Rule 10. Traffic Separation Schemes. A vessel using a traffic separation scheme shall 1. Proceed in the appropriate traffic lane in the general direction of traffic flow for that lane. 2. So far as practicable, keep clear of traffic separation line or separation zone. And 3. Normally join or leave a traffic lane at the termination of the lane, but when joining or leaving from either side, shall do so at as small an angle to the general direction of traffic flow as practicable. Vessel I was proceeding in the wrong direction in a traffic separation lane, without any good reason. This initial fault was compounded by the fact that she was proceeding too fast, and when action was taken by altering course to starboard, these alterations, of course, consisted of two very small alterations of 5 degrees each, and a further alteration of 20 degrees. That action was a clear breach of Rule 8B of the collision regulations. Both vessels C and E were proceeding much too fast when approaching the Dover Strait in dense fog. Neither vessel reduced speed when the presence of I was detected and was clearly a potential danger, and after ship E turned to starboard onto a collision course, the radar lookout on both vessels were not sufficiently effective, so that early avoiding action was not taken by either vessel. Ship C should have kept well clear of ship E. Failure to do so was matched by the failure of ship E to have proper regard for the presence of ship C, and both vessels should be treated as equally liable.